one of the standard rules is to have a quarantine unit, so that students will know that you must have a quarantine unit where you keep animals that are just coming from outside into your farm. You keep them for about 30 days.
Okay.
So you now check them, take their blood, take their feces, examine them, that they are not bringing any disease from outside.
Okay.
So that they are free.
Perhaps more heartwarming to the task of achieving the core mandate of FUNAP is the height accomplished in the areas of extension services and establishment of farms, not only as practicals for students, but also to advance the cause of making her host communities beneficiary of her intellectual findings and supply of the much needed food crops for sale at affordable prices. The sixth helmsman of FUNAB demonstrating the strong will of not being narrow-minded has kept faith with what he met on ground by consolidating and continuing on projects, ideas and innovations started by his predecessors. For instance, the strategic innovative establishment of community-based farms in all the four major areas of Ogun State by the administration of Professor Olaya Balogun to serve as practical farming and the translation of improved agricultural farming skills and seedlings to local communities have been further enhanced. These have further helped to forge the Ghana and town relationship which average towers ought to stand for anywhere they are sited. The farms are located in Ogun State at Odu Aloro near Odogolu in the Odogolu local government area for Jebu Division, Odelemo in the Shagamo local government area for Remo Division, Iweketu after Imeko in the Imekwafon local government for Yewa Division, and Shaga Orile in the Abeokuta North local government area for the Eba Division. A visit to all these farms reveals farming activities involving planting of cassava, maize, rice, yams, vegetables, and the fruits like cucumber during the planting season, covering large hectares of land donated to the institution at the different communities where such farms are located. Professor Sunday Adibo, who is in charge of the Center for Community-Based Farming Scheme, CUPFARS, in the course of the visit, was harvesting yams planted on over 1.2 hectares of land by students, farm managers and farm assistants on the university farm, few kilometers to the institution's main campus after Alabata. The harvested yams are meant for sale to the communities, both within and outside the locality. Professor Sunday Adibo speaks further on the 25 hectares of land meant for rice planting by the university.
For rice,
yes, sir.
Rice has never been planted since the onset of CUPFARS in 2010. This year we have planted 25 hectares. We planted two varieties, which we shall see later. We have Ofada,
okay,
which has a niche in Ogun State and far southwest in general. And also planted Faro. But during the drought, there was a setback.
Okay.
But God helped us, some recover and some did not. But we still have something to show for it.
Farm managers of each of these farms, such as these four different divisions of Ogun State, were also on ground to superintend over the farms, notwithstanding COVID-19 and also strike hindrances. Traditional rulers and community leaders in all these locations have this to say on their impressions concerning the farms in their respective locations, as well as on the person of the present leadership of FUNAB.
We willingly give them the land for the progress of the country.
Okay.
From there, there's any problem with the children, no quarrel with anybody. They are going up and down, there is nobody in the town that is stopping them.
It's an experience. Both sides gain a lot. The community gains one or two things from the children. The children too are well exposed between the other side of the community, not necessarily the training, the university, and just come out just like that.
The community and all the surrounding communities will in a way benefit. That is in terms of
transfer of knowledge, mutual exchange of ideas, and more so, we see the presence of young would-be people in agriculture at its very peak in our community. We believe we could gain a lot from that exercise.
Won duro ti ilu yi gbogbo ilu na de fi owo si ti ajo nse gbogbo awon ise titi di akoko yi ti o si igiri lowo kankan ninu e.
We enjoy the federal government of Funnab because the people are getting from them because they buy things from women, we learn, people learn how to do farming.
Professor Sarako has not been too far away from us. Even during this COVID-19 thing, they brought some items for the community, for which we are very thankful of. We know him, he's very close to us. We see him as this place as his second home.
Steve Salako, o je nkan to je pe won sumo wa ni isaga da laarin awon oloye wa okan ni won je nibe.
Aside from the community-based farming scheme, COPFAS, Funnab also has a farm services unit complementing both academic and practical activities to the benefits of the students, the staff, and those in the neighborhood through mechanized farming. The director, Directorate of University Farms, Mr. Joseph Olobashola, highlights the activities of the unit. The
farm was running mainly on manual. We're engaging manual labor. And you know, manual labor is getting scarce. And it's easy because it's quite, there is much drudgery in the farm and our youths will not want to take to farming. So we have to go as far as Cotonou in Benin Republic, even Togo, to get these migrant workers to come and work on the farm. We're having as many as 80 times. Even though they were doing a good job and we are having a good farm, but that is not the type of farm you want to use to teach students. So we've been blessed with a series of machineries with the brand new supplied by this administration. This, it plants maize, it plants soybean, you can plant rice. That soybean you are seeing here.
Germane to any activity on the university campus is the pursuit of learning in an enabling environment by staff and students. Despite the closure of schools as a result of the COVID-19 and the protracted nationwide ASA strike, Professor Salako's administration has not stopped looking at ways of ameliorating the condition of her students. Apart from providing the much-needed conducive learning environment with installation of electronic classroom boards, renovation of students' hostels, construction of new ones, the students' union building on ground has also undergone a facelift with the authorities' approval of an extension of an arena where students can relax or unwind. The Deputy Vice Chancellor of Academics, Professor Bolanle Akeredoluwale, discloses further on what the institution is working out to ensure higher academic excellence.
Practically all our programs have received, have been accredited. It's only the new program that we started That's mechatronics, partial accreditation.
Okay.
And that's hopefully in another 2 years when NUC, when they come back, we are sure that we'll get the full accreditation for that program. So we have 100%, so to say, full accreditation of all the programs on campus.
Professor Salako corroborates.
In the area of teaching, in the area of research, in the area of extension, the university has proven itself excellently. Our teaching facilities, we keep improving on them. You've seen our laboratories, we keep improving on them for research. And then we have scholars who are good enough to win grants.
The university boss has also, for the first time in the history of the institution, appointed a woman as the Dean of Students Affairs. She is Professor Adebukola Mobolaji Omemo, a professor of food, microbiology and safety, and was appointed on the 2nd of January 2020. But what is the perception of the students on the administration? The leader of the Students' Union, Mr. Michael Oluide, speaks.
Proactive and responsive to student matters. Now the hostels are actually under construction to give it a befitting look, and at least necessary amenities have actually been put in place with respect to that. When we talk of the lectures, or at least we can see that there are facelifts in most of the lectures we have now compared to what we have before. Now when we are talking of the student union building too, because the student union has actually been a beneficiary of this benevolence. At least they put the necessary measures in place to make sure that the student union building is being renovated.
Maintaining cordial relationship among the various industrial unions on campus is no doubt a Herculean task. But for the current administration, the favor from above and compassionate disposition to all have been of great benefits. The Vice Chancellor explains.
But I work with unions to the extent that I will not abdicate my responsibility as a leader. I respect people in spite of propaganda, deliberate disinformation. I get my work done. I don't get distracted. There is personalized unionism, there is personalized personalization of unions. We have that. But if you come to me, we have dialogue, suggestion that we agree or disagree, the points must be made known. So I have no problem with any union, including student union.
The university orator, who is also an academic staff, Professor Christian Ikeobi, assesses the administration and the person of the Vice Chancellor, Professor Felix Salako.
One thing that has been clear in the last 3 years is that we have had as Vice Chancellor someone who is accessible, somebody who is open, and somebody that is easily approachable, and he knows the system and the system knows him. We have not had any crisis for the students, and for the staff I can also say we have not had any serious crisis on the part of staff unions.
The chairman of the National Association of Academic Technologists, NATS, Funnab Chapter, and Zonal Coordinator, Southwest Zone of the Association, Comrade Olunide Oluremi Joseph, eulogized the person of the VC and Arts More on his administration.
To allude to the fact that he's an excellent administrator, he's a trained administrator, because he did not just jump into office. He gone through the tutelage of being a vice chancellor. When it comes to welfare of staff, under the administration of Professor Felix Kolawole Salako, it has been noble and perfect. He's a man that knows what to do at the right time without being coerced. And that informed the relative peace that we have been experiencing since November 4, 2017.
Similarly, the chairman of the Senior Staff Association of Nigerian Universities, FUNAB chapter, and incidentally an alumnus of FUNAB, Comrade Oluretimi Fasunwo, had the courage to score the administration.
Within the last 3 years, I will still put him in 75%, because if we want to compare this administration, let's say at least in the last 5 years, he has spent 3 years. Professor Salako is an administrator. He's a man that is approachable, that you must have your facts. He's a man who cares about the welfare of the people, regardless of your religion, ethnicity, sex, whether you're a student or a staff. In terms of welfare, particularly health-wise, he's somebody who has passion and sympathy for people's health. I want to believe that if he has opportunity to manage the kind of resources FUNAB management in the past have, we all must have enjoyed him better.
While the administration was keenly focusing on taking the university to greater heights, Professor Salako was equally mindful of ensuring that promotion of staff was not denied. In a 7th December 2020 FUNAB bulletin, 329 non-teaching staff, both senior and junior, were promoted, while 14 others were converted to officer cadre. Without mincing words, the engine room of whatever has been recorded as achievement so far by the administration is the registrar's office. Dr. Hakim Bola Adekola is the registrar. He recalls the state of affairs at the inception of the administration and how the captain of the ship has been navigating the affairs of the university.
We came in at a time that there was a lot of turbulence. The middle pass administration had critical issues with unions, and which has led to what I can call factionalization in the campus. But with God on our side, and with the kind of leadership we have in the Vice Chancellor, who is ready to listen and listen all over again, by explaining decisions, why they are taken and why it is in the interest of everybody. The unions were on one point call away, and that has assisted us in managing the unions that we have, the industrial peace that we have on campus.
The exchequer and also a principal officer of the institution, the bossa, Mr. Chukwu Nweke Ezekwiazu, FCA, whose pivotal role of ensuring funds to oil the engine of both academic and non-academic activities, affirms that the Vice Chancellor was not discriminatory on who originates a project, but much concerned about its completion and relevance to the overall well-being of the academic community.
He's a very practical person who will try to find out whether things are going according to plan.
With the new normal all over the world, how has the institution been able to weather the storm of COVID-19?
We saw what was coming. We saw what was coming, because by the time farming activities should start, there was lockdown. And we knew that that would imply that food production would be hindered in 2020. So we set up post-COVID-19 farms to work against hunger.
On the part of the Governing Council of FUNAB, it was commemoration for the federal government for ensuring regular funding of universities. At a recent inspection of newly acquired equipment for various laboratories and offices in the university, the Pro-Chancellor and Chairman, Governing Council of FUNAB, Dr. Aboki Zawa, lauded the Vice-Chancellor, Professor Salako, for using available funds judiciously. But what kind of a man is the Vice-Chancellor?
He's a very hard-working man. And the good thing is that, he's very understanding. He endears himself to the students. And I think the students key into this, so they're able to relate with him very well.
Professor Salako is a quintessential administrator. He's a proactive leader.
I said he's a person who shows leadership. And he doesn't sit down. He goes out to see that things are done according to plan.
In all of these, what can he attribute to the visible giant strides FUNAB has recorded in the last 3 years?
I think the basic thing is relationship with individuals and agencies. When I say relationship, how do you present yourself when you get to the people who are supposed to help you? Are you humble enough to make your request? I think that's the magic one. Respect for people and letting them see the need for certain things to happen.
What should now be agitating his mind as his constant home on the remaining 2 years left for the tenure of office is how to ensure that the strides attained are not wished away, but sustained and widened.
My vision and mission was titled, and we still titled, excellence cannot be compromised. If you are not going to compromise excellence, I think what shall happen in the next 2 years is that we shall have more of excellence, because there is no limit to excellence. We shall work more, we shall remain dedicated to the vision and mission, and we shall remain with God.
A person who is worthy of being a leader wants power, not for himself, but in order to be of service. Sam J. Evan Jr., former U.S. Senator. Exactly the essence of what the last 3 years in office of Professor Salako has been as Vice Chancellor for FUNAB, with the ultimate that standards will not be compromised as it looks forward to the completion of his tenure of office.